Dr. G. Vaja, working as assistant professor in SLH department, St. Martin Engineering College. Now today I am going to teach about beta and gamma functions. These are also called as special functions. Before going to teach beta and gamma functions, now we'll discuss algebraic functions and transcendental functions. These are called some other functions that are types of functions. So first, what is a function? A function, an expressible rule, comma, a law that defines a relationship between one variable to another variable. A relation between one variable to another variable. Either variables are independent variable or dependent variable. For example, if you take any function, y is equal to, defined by y is equal to f of x. Here x is the independent variable. And y is the dependent variable. Y is the dependent variable. Okay? So now we have so many types of functions that are, so first one is algebraic function. Algebraic function. Example for that, algebraic functions are polynomials, rational and irrational. So what is algebraic function? So an equation, a function is called algebraic function. It can be, a function is called algebraic function. It can be constructed by using algebraic operations. It can be constructed by using algebraic operations such as additions, comma subtractions, multiplications and divisions, okay, etc. For example, if you take any polynomial equation, so that is ax square plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is a like a quadratic form. Okay, so it is also one example for the algebraic function. Okay, and any cubic equation is also example for the algebraic function. And then transcendental function. The second one is transcendental function. A function is not expressible. A function is not expressible. Algebraic operations that are like logarithmic functions, trigonometric functions, and also exponential functions. These are not expressible algebraic operations that are like addition, subtractions, multiplications, etc. So for example, if you take algebraic functions, so like f of x is equal to some sin x, comma log x, comma e power x. These are the examples of transcendental functions. Okay, and special functions are there. In that, that is the third type of functions that are called special functions. Okay, what are the special functions here? For example, for that is, we need to take beta and gamma functions are the special functions. Okay, these are also definite integrations and also it is the improper integrations. So first discuss beta function. What is the definition of beta function? A definite integral of the form integral 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 into 1 minus x whole power n minus 1 into dx is called beta function, where m is greater than 0 and n is greater than 0. It is denoted by beta of m comma n or v of m comma n and read as beta of m comma n. Beta of m comma n. So what is this, can be written as beta of m comma n, nothing but what? Integral 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 into 1 minus x whole power power n minus 1 into dx, where m comma n or greater than 0. This is the definition of beta function. So observers, what is the definition of beta function? A definite integral of the form integral 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 into 1 minus x whole power n minus 1 into dx. That is called beta function definition, and it is denoted by beta of m comma n, and also it can be written as v of m comma n is equals to integral 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 into 1 minus x whole power n minus 1 into dx. We have some properties of this beta function. So what are the properties of this beta function? So now we have total 4 properties of beta function. So the first property is symmetry property. V of m comma n is equals to V of n comma m. This is nothing but symmetry property. So the second one is trigonometric property, that is half into V of m comma n is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta cos power 2m minus 1 theta into d theta, and also this can be written as V of m comma n is equals to 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta into cos power 2n minus 1 theta into d theta. This is the second property of beta function. Now the third property of this is V of m comma n plus 1 is equals to V of m plus 1 comma n. This is the third property of beta function. And the fourth property is V of m comma n is equals to m minus 1 into n minus 1 factorial by m plus n minus 1 whole factorial. What are the properties of beta function? V of m comma n is equals to V of n comma m. This is called symmetric property of beta function. And half into V of m comma n is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta into cos power 2n minus 1 theta into d theta. So and also this can be written as V of m comma n equal to 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta into cos power 2n minus 1 theta into d theta. Now the third property of beta function is V of m comma n plus 1 is equal to V of m plus 1 comma n, and the fourth property is this one. Okay, now show that one property, the first property is symmetry property, and show that V of m comma n is equal to V of n comma m. This is the property one in beta function. Okay, so now first we have, going for the solution, we have V of m comma n is equals to, by the definition of beta function, we know that V of m comma n is equals to integral 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 into 1 minus x whole power n minus 1 into dx, where m comma n are greater than 0. Okay, and this is equation number 1. And we have V of m comma m is equals to what? Is equals to integral 0 to 1 x power, just replace m by n here, x power n minus 1 into 1 minus x whole power m minus 1 into dx. Okay, now we have to show that. Now we have to show that V of m comma n is equals to V of n comma m. Okay, so put from this equation 2, 1 minus y in equation number 1, I am giving place x minus 1 is equals to minus y. So then dx, differentiating on both sides, dx is equals to minus dy. Now we can change the intervals also here. When upper limit x is equals to, what is the upper limit here? X is equals to 1, and the lower limit is x equal to 0. So now when x is equals to 1, then y is equals to what here? 0. When the lower limit x is equals to 0, then y is equals to 1. Substitute these two in this equation number 1, then we will get what? V of m comma n is equals to integral in this lower limit. When the lower limit x is equals to 0, then substitute y is equals to 1 and the upper limit is equals to 0. And your x is equals to what? 1 minus y whole power m minus 1 and into 1 minus x. 1 minus x is equals to what? 1 minus y whole power m minus 1 into dx is equals to what? Minus dy, right? So now here negative sign is there, we can change the intervals. That can be written as integral 0 to 1. So it is 1 minus y whole power m minus 1 into 1 minus 1 plus 2y whole power n minus 1 into dy. That is equal to V of m comma n is equals to integral 0 to 1. 1 minus y whole power m minus 1. These two get cancelled. Y power n minus 1 into dy. So go for the second equation. In this V of n comma m equal to integral 0 to 1. X power n minus 1 into 1 minus x whole power m minus 1 into dx. Now put here y is equal to x. Y is equal to x. Then dy is equals to dx. Here the upper limit and lower limit are same. The lower limit and upper limit are same. Why? Because y is equals to x. Then V of m comma n is equals to integral 0 to 1. Substitute y is equals to x here. 1 minus x whole power m minus 1 into x power n minus 1 into dx. That is nothing but what here? That is nothing but V of n comma m. Okay, so this is the property of 1 in beta function. And now I am going to tell about gamma function. So what is the definition of gamma function? What is the definition of gamma function? A definite integral is of the form integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x power n minus 1 into dx, where n is greater than 0. It is called gamma function and it is denoted by gamma n. It is denoted by gamma n and read as gamma n. And read as gamma n. The gamma function is defined for all n is greater than 0. For all positives of n values. And the gamma function is defined for all negative fractions. The gamma function is defined for all negative fractions. But the gamma function is not defined for all negative integers and n is equals to 0. What are the properties for this? Gamma of 1 is equals to 1. This is a very important property. And gamma of n is equals to n minus 1 into gamma of n minus 1. This is the second property of gamma function. And gamma of n is equals to gamma of n plus 1 by n plus 1. These are the most important properties of gamma functions. Okay, now I am going to tell about gamma. Show that gamma of 1 is equals to 1. Okay,